UConn as much as we do, since we're the flagship station of UConn sports. Exactly.
Deal
with
it.
We're the national champs. That's everybody right. Else can suck it.
You're listening to the Rob Dibble Show.
All right, we are back live from Dunkin Park. Got a couple of my players here, Marco Russomano and Jack Reeder, two of my favorite kids.
All right.
We're going to let Jack talk first, but he's rocking a Norm Charlton Rob Dibble shirt with the picture of us on the top of Riverfront.
This dude's whole getup, man. He's got the purple Jordans. Yeah, show off the shoes.
Oh, yeah, well.
The drip, man, is what they call it.
That's right.
He has got the Under Armour pants, but the shirt is you and Norm, the famous picture on top of Riverfront Stadium sitting on the lights. That is a homemade, one-of-a-kind shirt
awesome.
The dude's wearing. But you got to talk about the chain game that
he's
this
got
dude
some chain
has.
Game. It's well, got my whole team, though, man. I don't know. Jack can speak to this. Do you guys compete on how you look and stuff like that? I mean, you guys all wear the face paint and do all that kind
of
stuff?
Yeah, some of the time. But most of the time, we try to, like, sometimes we coordinate it. Sometimes we, like,
do it
together.
You
so just
do.
Just to look cool.
Oh, I mean, my favorite thing is, although one of my biggest rules is what? What's one of my number one rules? No questions.
Yes.
No questions. We're all in a group chat. It's just fire question after question.
Of course.
What shirt we wearing, coach?
Yeah.
What is this? What is that? What
mm-hmm.
is, it cracks me up to no end. So I can't have rules anymore because they don't follow them anyway.
Now, do you play with the chain?
I do.
Oh, yeah.
I do.
Wow. How is it playing with the chain?
It depends on the day. If it's a little colder outside, I'll keep it out. But if it's warmer, I'll try to keep it in.
Listen to that.
I know.
Man.
I love
the system.
That. Excellent. You guys got it going on.
All right. Give the mic to Marco.
Now, Marco, his drip. He's
Russo.
Straight out of football practice. Straight out of Southington. Rocking the flat bill yard goat's hat. The decaled, I guess we would call that the transverse style
yard
goat's
hat. Yeah, that is a pretty cool yard goat's hat.
So what about face paint, Marco? What do we do for face paint for you?
All over the face. It's drip.
What, just take the hands and just wipe your cheeks wherever
no,
it goes?
No, but they have like different shapes and stuff.
Yeah.
Why do you do the certain shapes that you guys do? Do you pattern it after anybody?
Nah, just put it on.
Marco, does it have anything to do with keeping the sun out of your eyes?
No.
Nope. All right, so let me ask Marco this. You just had the first day of school, right?
Yep.
Did you have to pick out your outfit ahead of time? Are you worried about how you look when you get to school?
Of course you are.
No, not really.
Is he lying? Lauren, is he lying?
No.
So
he's lying.
Let me get this
You're
straight.
Lying. Jack, give the mic back to Jack.
You guys could care less about the school drip, and you only care about how you look on the field. Look good, play good.
Nah, you just got to look good.
Look good, period.
You don't worry about how you look to school?
No, I got to look good all the time.
Jack's different. Jack's always got to look on point, basically. All right, tell me some I want to know some – first of all, we call you Coach Rob. Is that what we're calling you?
They call me Coach Rob.
Coach Rob. Give me some Coach Rob cliches. Like, what are some of the one-liners that he says on the field, either when you're doing something good, doing something bad? Give me some of your favorite little Coach Rob quotes.
I love when he doesn't agree with the ump. He's like, are you kidding me? Are you serious? Are you kidding me?
That is not just umpires. That goes across the
what
board.
What do I
sir.
Tell you? I didn't bring you here to be good. I brought you here to be what?
Great.
Oh, I love that one. That's a good one. Marco, do you got anything in your back pocket, Coach Rob says?
No. No questions. Like you said, no questions.
That's awesome.
I never want you guys to feel sorry for yourselves,
yeah.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Nobody cares.
Yep.
Nobody cares about you feeling sorry for yourselves.
So what's the best part about playing baseball? Just playing baseball.
Hitting good, playing good, looking good. Yeah.
Marco's impressive, though. Marco,
Deion Sanders.
Marco's
answer.
Great catcher, pitcher. He'll play some left field. He's really been great in the outfield. Then Jack is a really good outfielder, really has come through with pitching this year. Could not believe how many times he was gunning people out from the outfield. Then
nice.
Marco started doing – our outfielders were unbelievable defensively this year.
Give me something that you guys weren't good at all, and now you're, like, thirsty for that kind of play or that kind of situation that you are good at.
We usually start, like, mid-game, starting to hit and stuff. Like
second time through the lineup?
Yeah.
Is there anything just like drill-wise that you did and like, man, I don't really like taking grounders at third base, but nowadays, like, bring it on. I'll take it off my chest.
I don't know. Just
I'm not that hard on them. First of all, we don't play on the kind of fields that I want to rip ground balls at these guys.
No.
I don't want to take their teeth out. So, yeah. But they do great. They're fantastic.
This is what I really wanted to know. What did you know about Coach Rob before you got on the team?
The fight with Lou Piniella.
Yep, of course. Yeah. Jack, you got anything different than that?
I don't know. Was that maybe that's when he's interesting when he threw the ball at the guy going to first base?
DeCenzo, yeah. When he bunted on him, he just threw it at him. Now, was this like a session that all you kids had around YouTube one day and like we got to look up Coach Rob and all this stuff we've heard?
Like when I made the team first, what was that, 2-3 years ago? I was like, I've heard the name, but I've never looked him up. But he was dirty, like he was
nasty.
He
is
was
the word.
Nasty boys.
Right, exactly. Now, is there more? Have you seen any more YouTube clips, or you just stick to the DeCenzo and Lou Piniella fight?
I just knew he kicked some butt. Whenever somebody didn't like him, he would show him the right way.
Now, I want to know this, because if I was on Rob Dibble's team and I know that stuff, and even if they do or they don't, I would act accordingly, like arms folded, like I got this dude. Go look him up on YouTube. Do you guys have that attitude when you take the field knowing that this guy's on third base coaching?
No, I mean, I know he's a 99 in the show, so we always carry that with us.
That's another thing I want to know. 99 in the show, he's talking about a video game, and he's talking about his player rating in the show. When did you guys discover Coach Rob was in MLB The Show?
I think when his card first came out, he was – him and his card and Randy Johnson's card are pretty dirty. They throw fast, and they have good movement on them.
And then when you do this and you actually like win baseball games or lose baseball games in your video game world, do you ever thank Coach Rob for that video game win or no? It's nothing he did.
I've posted him on my story a couple times saying thank you, Coach. How was it going? You saved me the game.
And there's Ryan Clavis right there. By the way, didn't even know that was me coaching him that was in MLB The Show.
Awesome. We got more kids that just showed up.
Give the mic to Ryan.
Who else we got? Ryan.
So, Ryan, how long did it take for you to figure out that I was the same guy that was in MLB The Show this year? Like, hold it close to your mouth. 2 months in?
Month and a half.
That's just funny. That's so hilarious.
I love my kids.
That's
awesome. I love my kids. Give the mic to Ben.
All right, Ben.
Ben's one of my favorite
rocking
kids.
The Cincinnati. First of all, I got to tell everybody's outfits. Ryan looks like he just got out of the pool.
that's his look. They all have their own look, though. Man.
Ryan's
they all
a cool
have their own look.
I feel like you'd put the moniker Cool Breezer.
He is a Cool Breezer.
He's a Cool Breezer.
Yep.
All right, Ben is rocking the Cincinnati jersey. What Cincinnati jersey is that? Is that a Dibs?
Yeah, it's a Dibs jersey.
49.
Oh,
dude,
see, that's why
that
I love
awesome.
Me some
that
Ben
is Lasser. Awesome.
Look at that kid.
Excellent. So, Ben, where are you at? Well, tell me about Ben.
Ben's awesome.
Where's he
great
playing?
Great catcher, pitcher, third base, anywhere I put him, first base. Hits the snot out of the ball.
Now, do you have any Coach Rob cliches that are in the back of your head that you
your mom actually
with?
Just texted me one. What do I tell you not to do a lot of? Apologizing.
Yeah,
it
he doesn't
drives
want
me.
To say sorry.
Don't
no,
be sorry.
No. Yeah.
I love them just the same, even when they screw up. I don't care. They don't have to be sorry.
Now, do you take that off the field? Do you try not to apologize so much when your daily life?
Sometimes. I see him saying, don't apologize. Sometimes.
Be
like,
sorry.
Out at school, I'll see it.
These people don't have to
out
like
home,
it. When you
I'll
guys are playing other sports, I don't want you to be sorry.
All right, we got another Reds jersey behind Ryan.
That's Ryland. That's Ben's brother. This
oh,
kid.
Oh, excellent.
My God, so he just went
we
to Cooperstown.
Got bros?
Oh, yeah. So these are siblings. So – ask him about it. He's been to Perfect Game.
No way.
He's been to Cooperstown. This kid kicks some serious tail.
He's
how many home runs you hit
Reds
at Cooperstown?
Jersey.
Hold the mic up to your mouth.
I hit eight.
Eight home runs? How many games are we playing there?
We played eight.
Home run a game?
Well, what, you hit three in one game though, right?
I hit two home runs in two games.
All right, so when you become a Major League Baseball player, college baseball player, high school baseball player, baseball has a way of just you memorize everything. You memorize what the count was. You memorize the pitch. Give me those pitches. What were those three pitches? Who was pitching them to you, and why did you crank them over the fence?
Most of them I saw were, like, fastballs that were low or
Now, were you thinking fastball?
Most of the time, yes.
Now, when did you start facing curveballs?
2 years ago.
And was that difficult? Like, when you made that, somebody finally
threw
you?
Some of them were.
And then what was the thing that kind of?
Remember, Ryland's a big kid. He's 12, though.
What? Jeez.
I know. So
I need to see. Dude, and you're like the kid from Chinese Taipei.
Here's the thing. He should be able to hit a curveball because he's got a great curveball.
Nice.
So he knows the rotation, and he should be able to see where it comes out.
Like, being a pitcher and knowing kind of sequences, knowing what people are doing, learning from this guy what people are trying to do to you at the plate, how much does that help you as a hitter?
A good amount. Very good amount.
So you think about that kind of thing, like, every single time? Now, before you became part of the Smash Factory, before you started rolling with these teams, did you have that in mind at all, even watching baseball?
Yes.
You did?
Yep.
Now, do you
– These guys are shaking their heads no.
Ben says
but
no.
But this kid, he's kind of a savant.
Savant. He's watching a lot of ball.
They are all crazy. They love the sport. That's the thing I'm the most proud of. They're so passionate for baseball. They won't stop playing. That's like they're this is the generation right here. That's all they want to do is play baseball.
But the other thing we were talking when Jack and Marco sat down, Marco plays football.
Yep.
Jack plays soccer. You guys play other sports as well?
Some basketball.
Ben plays hoops. You guys play hoops. Ryan, you play hoops. Excellent.
Yeah, Ryan's 6'1", going on 6'2", so he better be playing some basketball.
And we talk about that all the time. Like, even some of the biggest programs, we talk about this with Gino and his girls. His girls can't throw a basketball overhand because all they've done is play basketball.
Well, I want them to. I want them to throw basketballs, footballs. I tell them all the time, throw different heavy balls to help your baseball throws. Get back to Ryan. I want to talk to Ryan about his hair. So this is the look. Of
everyone.
14,
this
15, you know, you baseball players. This is what they all look. Handsome kid, but what's up with the hair?
What's up with the hair? He's got big, bushy hair. I would
call it. All the way around, though. Yeah. It's all the way around.
Honestly, I think it's like Floyd from Dazed and Confused, man. Like, he's the cool breezer of the team.
They're bringing back the 70s.
It is the 70s look, Ryan.
It looks good with the hat on.
Totally true.
The lady who cut my hair today said that. There's a guy in the Red Sox organization got his hair cut at the salon I was at today, came in with his hat on and said, you have to make sure it looks like this when I'm done.
Awesome.
Now, so that's their big thing is their look.
Give me the 1 out of 10 on the bobblehead. What do you think as far as looks exactly like Dibs is a 10 and looks nothing like Dibs as a 1?
I'd give it 8.5.
8.5. Excellent. What do you think pulls it down from a 10?
The jersey.
The jersey?
That's my high school.
That's Southington.
And it's the
anti-Southington?
It's the Yard Goats. Yeah, they don't like Southington's good in baseball. Yeah.
I get it. Totally get it.
I like that, though. See?
Question of the interview. How fast do you want him to throw the first pitch today?
Yeah, hard as
hard as he can. Oh, my God. This is going to be great.
All
so
right.
I'm expecting 45 mile an hour. I'm expecting lob job. Which, no shame in that, big fella. You don't – listen, these guys might make fun of you for a day, but they're going to forget about
Peter,
it.
Peter, come here.
Peter.
Stop pouting back
you
there.
You answer this question.
This kid can play too. And tell them about your defenders team. You won, what, the Newberg tournament?
Yeah.
Awesome.
No, these dudes are studs,
love
man. They can
jersey.
Play.
By the way,
Peter, why did you cut all your hair off?
Because I felt like it.
Plus,
he does not apologize.
Peter felt like wearing a huge puka shell beaded
necklace.
Well,
there's a lot of my guys do that. That's a look, though.
I love those jerseys.
Going on.
Question is, mile per hour wise, where do you think Dib should clip here on the first pitch?
As hard as he can.
I can't hit. I might hit 70, but it might hurt really bad.
All right, do they understand?
They don't
what
know.
A torn
they don't understand
labrum
what
is,
60 feels like.
Miss labrum is. How fast are we seeing? Like, how fast pitches are
they're
these
guys? They're seeing some 80 plus, 85.
Really?
Some close. I think the kid from Technique Tigers. I thought he was upper 80s that they faced.
Do you guys rather like the fastball stuff, like dare you can hit it, or would you rather face a guy that throws a bunch of junky curveballs and sliders and stuff?
Fastballs.
Dude,
they're all really good hitters, too.
I feel for you because if I were you, I'd lob it and I'd, you know, take the strike and then walk off and wave my funny hat. But now they have put some serious pressure on you.
There's no pressure. It's only one pitch. I don't have to throw a game.
Dude, you don't have a labrum in your shoulder.
I don't have most of my rotator cuffs going, too.
Does Coach Rob pitch? Does he throw BP
no.
every now and then?
I know that.
Excellent.
I don't want to hurt them. I can't consistently just throw it in there. So
I think everybody wants to know, has there been a moment where Coach Rob has gone insane? Oh, everybody says one time. Ben, what was the one time? I want to know
the one time.
Marco's got it.
Marco,
what happened, Marco?
All right, so there was one time where our third baseman, I guess he got called for obstruction or something.
That's right.
Yep.
This is one of the most BS calls I've ever seen.
He came running onto the field arguing.
Because they threw him out.
They threw him out, too.
They threw him out. Lewis was fake tagging the guy, and I will admit this. I didn't know this was a 14-U rule. Because I'm like, I think it's the stupidest thing I've ever seen. So you can't deke somebody to make them slide.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so the first time he did it, I've had issues with this home plate umpire in 17U baseball. So the first time he warned him, and I said, warned him for what? He's like, you can't fake tag somebody. I'm like, why not? Why not? Make the guy get down. I mean, I think it's brilliant.
I agree.
He did it in the major leagues.
It's a great
So then he
move.
Did it again,
yeah.
And he threw him out of the game.
Oh,
he says,
man.
I warned you. So then I called Mike Crispino. Mike Crispino said, now Mike Crispino obviously is the voice of UConn sports.
But he's
a high school umpire.
Yeah, exactly.
And he said, no, you don't usually eject kids for that, but you do reward an extra base for that.
Did you guys immediately get, scared? No, not at all. You knew he was going to keep his cool. You just were kind of sitting back and enjoying the action on this one. All right, Ben's got another one. What's the other one?
Well, to tack onto that, I mean, the quote from that one was that when the umpire told Coach Rob that he didn't know the rules of baseball, that one was funny. We were all dying in the dugout from that one.
You didn't tell me that part.
Oh, yeah.
He said, I don't know the rules.
John, I get the mic for a second. So,
that's what the umpire told him.
Their parents start heckling me. Their parents start talking smack.
Of course.
You're a major leaguer. You're a fake. What were they saying?
Fake major leaguer.
Nice. All smoke and mirrors, right?
Excellent.
That's why our 15U team will be called what?
We'll be the Smoke Baseball.
CT Smoke.
Awesome.
And who designed the backward K?
I did.
Bend
oh,
it.
Man. That's awesome. I just saw that.
Oh,
Excellent stuff.
These kids are awesome.
Excellent stuff.
So are you guys excited to be here tonight?
Yeah.
Go ahead. Give it to the reader.
Yeah.
This is a radio show. You guys have to speak.
Yeah.
There you go.
Excellent. So we're all in school. Everybody's back to school already.
Yep. Look at the depression on their faces.
I know. Everybody dropped their head a little bit. Summer was so awesome. I can't believe it's over already. I know. Man, we thank you guys for being here.
Absolutely.
Big time.
Of course.
Awesome. Dressing up like you dressed up.
Yep.
Even you, Ryan. I mean, you coming in as a cool breezer is right on brand.
Rylan, what's on the back of that?
Oh, another Dibble 49. Yeah. Have you guys, because I've experienced this just being the co-host here, and we'll probably experience this a lot tonight, there'll just be randos that walk by and they'll just scream, Dibble! Does that happen at Little League games?
No, really? I really experienced that.
Excellent. Does anybody try to challenge him at all, like throwing pitches or anything at Little League?
Oh. No way? Yeah, we went to a tournament in Delaware, and every five kids we went by, Dibble, can I get a picture? Dibble, can I get a picture? And we made it like an inside joke on our team.
That's great.
It's all good.
That's
I love
great.
My kids.
Awesome.
They're great. They're the best.
We're going to have fun tonight.
All right,
man.
We'll take a quick break. We'll come back. Final segment of the Rob Dibble Show with Ben Darnell live from Dunkin Park next.
Well done. 97.